बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट, आई एम ज़िशान तारिक योर फिज़िक्स टीचर एंड दिस वीडियो इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ एपसेक ऑनलाइन सपोर्ट प्रोग्राम। दिस वीडियो इज़ फॉर 10th स्टैंडर्ड एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ दिस लेसन इज़ फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज। वी विल लर्न व्हाट इज़ ऑडियबल फ्रीक्वेंसी रेंज, व्हाट इज़ अल्ट्रासाउंड एंड इन विच फील्ड अल्ट्रासाउंड इज़ यूज। नाउ शैल स्टार्ट आवर लेक्चर। First of all, audible frequency range. Audible frequency range is the number of frequencies or range of frequencies, or you can say that it a block of frequencies under which a human ear can listen. As this range is from 20th hertz to 20,000 hertz. Means if a sound is have a frequency of 20 hertz, it can also be heard by human ear, and if any sound possess a 20,000 hertz frequency, then it will also heard by human. But if any sound is less than 20 hertz, it cannot be listened by any human, and if it is greater than 20,000 hertz, it cannot also be listened. Reason behind this is our eardrum. The eardrum present in ear cannot vibrate more than 20,000 hertz, means its vibration decrease more than 20,000 vibration per second. Same like it cannot vibrate for a sound which have less or more smaller energy below than 10 hertz or 20 hertz. This range affected by age factor also, but in general its range is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz, and normally each and every human can listen this in this range. But child can listen more than 20,000 hertz sounds, but our old age humans such as more than 50 years, it cannot hear even 15,000 hertz sound. So age factor also vary audible frequency range. Now our next topic is ultrasound. Ultrasound means a sound which have frequency more than 20,000 hertz. It's simple definition of ultrasound. Ultrasound also have very high energy and its frequency is more than 20,000 hertz. Now we will discuss under which fields ultrasounds are used. There are many fields present in world where ultrasounds are used, but we will discuss fewer here which are also present in your textbook. First of all, we will discuss cleaning. Cleaning means ultrasound, a high frequency sound is used for cleaning purpose. Mostly this cleaning involves the tooth cleaning. If you have visited any dentist, there is apparatus which is possess a high frequency sound, but we only feel vibrations. We cannot hear that sound because its frequency is more than 20,000 hertz, and your eardrum cannot vibrate with this speed. So we cannot hear that sound, but we can feel vibrations. Now let me show you this process through an animation here. This is transmitting an ultrasound which will cause the dust particles or the sticky particles attached to the tooth, and they will vibrate very fastly and it will be removed from the tooth. This process is known as tooth cleaning, and ultrasound is mostly used for tooth cleaning. If you have ever visited dentist, then you will see this instrument present at that point. Now next one point is detection of cracks. Sometimes in industries there are very minor cracks present in ducts, in pipes, which cannot be detected by human eye. For that purpose we use ultrasound. How we use and how this technique is applied here. There is a transmitter. We transmit ultrasound through the duct. Here you can see that if there is no crack present in the duct, then same frequency and same energy sound will be received at the receiving side. But if there is a defect or there is any crack or there is any blockage, then there will be a disturbance in the sound and transmitted wave will not appear as on receiving side. If there is no crack, then transmitted wave will be received at receiving side with original energy and original frequency. But if there is a crack or there is a defective thing is present, then transmitted wave will be distorted and we will receive a low energy sound or low frequency sound. So it will tell us that there is a blockage or there is a crack present at that point. In this way, ultrasound is used for detection of cracks. Next one is our echocardiography. Here I will explain you through animation. This is same like detection of cracks. There are two instruments or two devices present. One is transmitter and second one is receiver. Transmitter transmit ultrasound to our human heart, and in human heart this receiver side will receive the sound. And as you know, there are certain things present or blood light is present, but each organ has its own density and its own construction. According to that construction, a image will be formed at the receiving side. The receiver will receive the ultrasound that is passing through heart and they will make a image on monitor. In this way, ultrasound is used for detection of any problem in heart valves or if there is any cavity present in heart, so we can detect through ultrasound. Next one is ultrasonography. I think you have visited so many times in hospitals, you have seen this apparatus. This is simply known as ultrasound that is used for the detection of kidney problems and other diseases such as pancreatic stones, kidney stones, kidney defects. So let me show you through a picture how ultrasonography works. Here you can see there are two pictures present. One is above and one is down. This one is the picture of a normal kidney or healthy kidney. When any doctor perform ultrasound, it compares the picture that obtained from the patient body and the picture that is of healthy kidney. Here you can see that in healthy kidney there is no cavity present and you can see a simple picture of kidney. But in defective kidney you can see that there are white cavities present here, and these white cavities shows that there are stones present in kidneys which have to be removed. This process is known as ultrasonography. Next one is also related to ultrasonography, lithotripsy. This process is used for the removal of stones from kidney. Before this process or before this procedure, a open surgery is performed for the removal of kidney stones. Now doctor only insert a duct which carry ultrasound. These ultrasound, here you can see that kidney stones are present in very big amount or its size, their size is very large, which cannot pass through this duct. But doctors transmit a ultrasound, a target ultrasound to these stones, and these stones will be broken into smaller pieces. Here you can see that the ultrasound is targeted on the stones and these stones are broken up into a smaller pieces. The doctors convert the larger stones into smaller pieces which can travel through this duct and it can be removed through our urine. This process is very healthy and it doesn't involve any open surgery or cutting surgery. Doctors only transmit a tube to the kidney side and they target ultrasound to the stones and they broke into the smaller pieces so it can be removed through urine in normal way. नेक्स्ट वन इज सोनार. सोनार इज अ एब्रीवेशन ऑफ साउंड एंड नेविगेशन. सोनार इज प्रोनाउंस्ड एज साउंड नेविगेशन एंड रेंजिंग सिस्टम. दिस प्रोसेस इज यूज टू डिटेक्ट सबमरीन्स और यू कैन सी शिप्स और अदर थिंग. लेट मी शो यू थ्रू ए पिक्चर. हेयर देयर इज अ सिंपल डायग्राम ऑफ सोनार. वन देयर इज अ ट्रांसमीटर विच ट्रांसमिट अल्ट्रासाउंड टू द डाउनवर्ड एंड देयर इज अ रिसीवर. वेन दिस साउंड विल स्ट्राइक विद द सी बेड इट विल अगेन रिफ्लेक्ट बैक टू द अपर साइड एंड रिसीवर विल रिसीव. This process is used for the detection of submarines. Also, it is used for the detection of depth of sea. Under some conditions or some places, seabed is very deep, but in some places it is at height. So this system is used for the detection of depth, and this there is a example present in your textbook, so you can also go through it how sonar is used to detect seabed. Next, here is the process of detection of submarines. A transmitter is transmitting sound ultrasound downward side. If there is any submarine present, then sound waves will reflect back to the receiver side, and receiver side will convert that sound into a picture format or into any symbol. So it will show that there is water. Next, again, this animation. Here you can see that ultrasound is transmitted by the ship. Whenever submarine comes closer to that ship, it will send a signal to the ship that there is something present under the water. This system is known as SNAR, and so simply you can say that sound navigation and ranging system, because in this system now we also detect or navigate the objects, but we can also detect their range at how much speed they are coming and how much their depth is present under the sea. Last one thing is echolocation. Echolocation means the detection of prey through sound. Mostly this method is used by dolphin and bat. This method also used by whales. What we do, these animals, they only transmit a ultrasound to each and every side. If there is any object is present or any prey or anything is present, then there will be a reflection of sound that will be heard by their ears, and they can navigate or they can locate their prey easily. Simply whale also use this method. It transmit a very large sound in the sea, and if there is any prey present, it will strike sound will strike to that prey and again reflect back to its side, and it can hear, whale can hear that sound, and it will move toward that side so he can eat that one prey. That's all for today lecture. Go through your textbook and repeat this lecture. Thank you and have a nice day.